Welcome everyone, I'm King of Valence, and thanks for watching this Spore video. Today, we are playing as the Grox in Cell Stage. This was done using Cheat Engine, and the process is very similar to a previous video where we started Cell Stage with a custom starting cell. And in that video, we tried to bring a creature into Cell Stage, but we couldn't get it to work at the time. When we selected a creature, then used Cheat Engine to load up Cell Stage, no creature would appear. However, we can apply an extra step using Cheat Engine to bring the Grox into the cell editor, save our creature as a cell, then load up Cell Stage, that will bring our creature into Cell Stage. We can expand on this idea of getting certain creation types in places they don't typically belong using this method as well. Using Cheat Engine but no other mods, in addition to getting creatures to act like cells, it's possible to get creatures as vehicles, vehicles as buildings, buildings as spaceships, spaceships as creatures, and creatures with spaceship parts. To get this to work using Cheat Engine, we will need to find four memory addresses. First, we need to find the address that controls what type of editor we're in. Second, the address that allows us to save our creation from the editor. Then the two addresses that control what stage is about to load. To find the address that controls what editor type we're in, we can go to the Create menu and load up the Early Creature Editor. The Early Creature Creator has this associated value, which will be our first search. All these values shown in this video will be included in a spreadsheet, which I'll go over in a bit. Next, load up the creature creator and search for this value. And there is only one address remaining. If there is more than one address left, keep switching between the editors and keep searching their corresponding values until only one address remains, then add it to the bottom list. We'll name this address editor type to keep track of them. Next, we can find the address that controls whether we can save our creation. Load up any regular creature from the Sporepedia that can be saved and search for 0. Then make the creature mouthless and search for 1024. Now we can drop our Grox into the editor, and the Grox can't be saved because of their cyborg parts, which is represented by the value of 32. There's the address to add to our list, and we can name it Save Creation. Finally, we need the two addresses that control what stage is about to load. Each stage has its own specific value to search. Cell stage is 0, creature is 1, tribal is 2, civilization is 4, and space is 5. Keep searching until only two addresses remain and add those to our bottom list as well. We'll call them Stage Load 1 and Stage Load 2. This was as far as we went last time with Cheat Engine, and using these will work for the rest of the video. However, these are only the dynamic memory addresses, which means they will change and need to be refound every time we load up Spore. For this video, we are also going to find the static memory addresses that don't change so we can easily input them directly into Cheat Engine in the future. That way we won't have to do all that searching again. We'll find the static memory addresses in the same order as the dynamic ones. To find the static or base address for the editor type, we need to ask Cheat Engine what accesses this address, and we get this instruction while the memory is in use. Notice this 18C here is our offset. That'll be important in a second. Click the instruction and go more information, and now we're going to search for this value as hex in Cheat Engine. And thankfully, this static address is really easy to find. This green address means we've already found the static address and we're almost done. Add this address to our bottom list and search for what accesses this address as well. Cause the value to change in-game so Cheat Engine can see it, then click on the instruction. And this right here is what we want, spore-app.exe plus this value. Copy this address, and now we can add an address manually, give it a pointer, paste that into the bottom part, and add the 18C offset from before. And this will immediately have the correct value for the creature creator. In the future, this is all we need to know to find the address that controls what editor we're in. When we reset Cheat Engine and Spore, we can just add this information and we'll get right back to the address without needing to search all those other values again. We'll name it editor type static, and we can delete the dynamic addresses since we don't need them anymore. Next, finding the static address that allows us to save our creation works the exact same way, and I'll show it as well for another example. First, ask what accesses this address, then cause a change in-game to create an instruction. A few instructions were made, but click the one that includes the offset number. For this address, we have an offset of 48. Click more information to find this value, and I'll show using a calculator where this value is coming from. This new value is actually just our original address value in hexadecimal, subtracted by our offset of 48 to find where this instruction is originating from. Search this value in Cheat Engine, and there's our green address we want. Ask what accesses this address as well, cause the value to change by putting back in our Grox creature, and that will create our new instruction. And once again, there's the address we want. Interestingly, it happened to be the same address as the editor type. Add an address manually, add the pointer, paste in the address, but remember this time we have the offset of 48. And this shows 32 for the Grox cyborg parts, so we know this address is connected to the right value. And this will be our save creation static address. Finally, we can find the two base addresses that control what stage is about to load. Unfortunately, these static addresses are more difficult to find, but I'll show an easy way to find it. Let's start the same way as before. Ask Cheat Engine what accesses this address and cause a change in-game. All these have the same offset of A4. Click one of them and more information, then search for this value. This time there are no green addresses right away. These last two addresses actually have three offsets, which means our static address is found from one of these nine new addresses, but we don't know which one. We have to add each of these nine addresses to our bottom list and see what accesses each of these, then find the one that has an instruction that corresponds to the in-game action we are looking for. For example, here's four of them. And when we change the stage, this is the address that gets the instruction written to it. So we know this is the address we want to keep searching with. The second offset is 628, so we know the next value to search for is this. Here's the real unfortunate part. We got 52 new results. We need to see what accesses each of these to find which one gets the next instruction in order to find the next offset. I won't show that here, I already did it, and the next offset is 8. But instead of doing all that searching again for those 52 addresses, since we now know the last offset is 8, we can do a pointer scan to reach the next step easier. On stage load 1, do a pointer scan for this address. Check this box so we can add our three specific offsets. Add these offsets in order. Remember, the first offset we found is the last offset in the chain, which was A4. Then 628, and I did the searching earlier with those 52 addresses and found it was 8. Click OK and save the pointer scan, and this loading bar will take a few seconds. Now we got 3600 results of what the static address could be. It is possible to narrow this down more by generating additional pointer maps, which I had to do to find the right one, but showing that process isn't that important for this video. Since I did all that before, I already know the address we're looking for only has three offsets. Sort by least number of offsets by clicking offset 4. And this address with just our three offsets in order will be the correct base address. Add this to our cheat engine list as stage load 1 static. And we can delete the dynamic addresses and all nine of those other addresses as well. Finding the base address for stage load 2 works the exact same way, but I'll just show how to find the address using the pointer scan and the offsets. Stage load 2 ends with A8, then 628, and 8 as well. Save and load the pointer scan, sort by least offsets, and here's our correct base address again. Also interesting that these two share the same base address with each other. And this will be stage load 2 static. When we want to manually add these addresses into Cheat Engine next time, they will look like this. These static addresses and offsets are also specific to the Steam version. Other versions of Spore may be different, but the process of finding them should be the same. I own a few versions of Spore, so I found these corresponding addresses and offsets, which are included in a spreadsheet in the description. This includes the earliest version of Spore installed from the DVD, Spore updated to patch 1.4 from the Galactic Adventures DVD, Galactic Adventures itself from the DVD, and Steam, which has the latest version, patch 1.5.1. If you have additional versions and are able to find their addresses and offsets, let me know in the comments and I'll add them to this table. Now we can go back to Cell Stage and see how we got the Grox into the Tide Pool. To get the Grox into Cell Stage, load up Space Stage and change the values of the stage load addresses to 0 so Spore thinks we're actually going to load up Cell Stage. Create a custom creature, and that will bring us into a cell editor. Every editor in Spore, just like the creature creators, has their own specific values. The current value in the editor type address corresponds to what I call the basic cell editor, since it only has these few cell parts available. I recorded all the editor's corresponding values and added them to this table, which is also included in the spreadsheet. So if we change the value for the basic cell editor in the editor type address to the creature creator value, this cell editor will now accept creatures into it. We can now drop a Grox into the editor, and we get a top-down view of the creature as if it's a cell. Spore won't let us save this creation normally, but if we change the value of the save creation address back to 0, this will allow us to save the Grox as a cell. We can see in the My Spore Creations folder, we have a top-down view of a Grox in the Cells folder. So changing the editor type will allow us to change what is accepted into the editor, but Spore will still save the creation as whatever editor type it originally was. We can now click through the menu and cell stage will load, and our Grox cell is there. Since we are using creature parts, they don't work in cell stage. We can't eat cell food with our creature mouth. However, we can kind of fake it though. Back in the cell editor with the Grox, we were cheating anyway, so let's use add DNA, and we can still use the parts list from the cell editor and put it on our creature. We can hide the mouth by shrinking it, and we can put whatever parts on we want to. Use cheat engine to save and load into cell stage. And it looks like we have a perfectly working creature in cell stage that eats and progresses through the game. Now we can extend this idea of getting different creation types in any editor we want beyond just creatures and cell editors. Let's choose the Military Land Vehicle editor, for example. The Military Tank editor has this value, which is recorded on the spreadsheet, but let's once again change this value back to the creature creator and drop in our Grox again. And yes, the game will actually accept creatures into this editor. Interesting, the body of the creature does not appear, only the parts. Here's another example with this creature, placed in the editor and still only the parts appear. Let's put the Grox back in, and just like the cell editor, we can still use the vehicle parts on our creature. Of course, Spore is very unhappy and does not want us to save, but using Cheat Engine we can save. And we can use this in Civilization Stage as a legitimate vehicle. We can now bring this vehicle back into Creature Stage with these vehicle parts included. Since we saved this creation in the vehicle editor, it is technically a vehicle, which we can see in our locally saved creations under vehicles. So while we are in the early creature editor before creature stage, we can change the editor type back to military land vehicle, and that will accept our Groxo car back in. Thankfully, the body of the creature is still saved in the PNG. Load into creature stage, and we have a creature with vehicle parts. Here's some other fun combinations using this editor swapping technique. Here in Civilization stage, we can swap our buildings for spaceships. It's the same idea, change the editor type address to whatever we want to be accepted into it. Here in the City Hall editor, we can replace the City Hall value with the value for the spaceship creator in Cheat Engine. Now we can drop our spaceship into the editor. And remember, we can still use whatever's in the editor parts list to be included on our combo creation as well. However, not all combinations work perfectly. From testing, I found there are basically two types of creations and editors. Editors that make living creations like cells, creatures, and captains, and editors that make non-living creations like vehicles, buildings, and spaceships. Living creations can be saved and work fine in both types of editors. However, purely non-living creations can still be viewed in living editors, but they can't be used like living creations. For example, here's a tank in the creature editor. The parts list can still be added, and Cheat Engine will save the creation, but the game always appears to crash once we interact with the creation. If we test drive this creation in the editor, the game crashes. If we try to view the saved creation card in the Sporepedia, the game crashes. And if we try to load this tank directly into creature stage, the game crashes. So this combination only appears to work in the editor and can't be saved. But this is still really cool. Maybe someone can make Lightning McQueen using this. There are many other applications for this technique, but that's a good place to start. I think this could unlock a lot of creative potential by mix and matching editor parts and getting some creations and stages where they don't normally belong. I'd love to hear what you come up with in the comments. Let me know if everything made sense, especially for Cheat Engine. I'll do my best to answer any questions in the comments as well. Thank you so much for watching, I'm King of Valence, and I'll see you next time.